Hi, today I would like to talk about Slavic chakras and how they represent, what are their names. And I would like to add that chakras are very popular term in Vedic or Indian tradition, but we can find almost the same in a Slavic tradition. So there are certain name for chakras in a Slavic tradition. I would like to add that this, according to my knowledge, maybe in your region you can find different name for this. So Azura, which are translated as lakes, is a well-known term for chakras in northern Russia. Also Krinitsy Sily is found in Belarus, Stogny in southern Russia, and different other terms. According to a Slavic tradition, there are 9 chakras, not 7. 7 chakras, as well known in a Vedic tradition, they correspond almost the same in the same areas as in Vedic or Indian tradition, and 2 chakras for left and right shoulder. So here on the picture we can see Slavic chakras as they come: Istok, Zarot, Zhivot, Persi, Lelya, Lada, Ustye, Chelo, Rodnik. Total 9 chakras. And these chakras are described in different ethnographers by different people. Some information you can find in the books of Mishalkin and Barantsevich. You can find also a lot of different energetic practice. I love it a lot, and I practice by myself. Also Adamovich describe Krinitsy Sily in his book. Arina Nikitina talks about it a lot, and I'm sure you can find other authors. So I hope by this video your knowledge of Slavic chakras expanded and you like it. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. Thank you.